That means we're going green. This time by Fenstermaker, bringing him around. Jonesy looking him over. And there they go. Fenstermaker and Naslin. Naslin with just a tidy, slightest bit edge down into turn number one. Fenstermaker now. Oh, and then Kramer and Nelson getting together there as they kind of beat and bang each other down the back stretch for the third spot. Kramer goes up high. Really, really high. I'm not sure if she's got a problem or what, but she's really up high and off the pace and now down into the infield, so bad news for Sierra there. Fenstermaker continues the lead in the double Ott car. Then it is Naslin, too, and they've kind of put a little bit of separation between them and Drew Nelson in the three car. Then Hill in the 68. Fay and Bartik, they are the six that are continuing to run here, heat number one of your Grand Casino Fear Stock class. Tammy closed that gap coming up out of turn two. She gets a really good run, but then it kind of evens out at about one car length between Aaron and Tammy. Right around the bottom they go. And Aaron doing a fantastic job of staying right on the tires. Now he drifts up just a little bit, opens that door for Tammy, and she will most likely have that inside line going down into turn number three. We'll have to see if that makes a difference. Aaron lets off. Tammy did not, but somehow Tammy able to stay right on the bottom. And she is your new leader here with four to go. Nelson, Hill, and Fay. Fay down low, right on the tires as well, and he's trying to get a little traction and get tucked up underneath the three of Drew Nelson, and Drew Nelson drifts high, and he looks out the left window and says, oh no, I'm getting passed. But he says, maybe I have an opportunity here. Gets into Faye just a little bit. Nice save there by the number 10 driver. He's up into the third spot. Nelson back to fourth, and Hill still in the fifth place spot. Fenstermaker going down low. Naslin, rather, gets pushed up just a little bit high. Two to go that time by. Down the backstretch, about 3 feet between them. Down to one to go at this time by. It'll be Naslin, Fenstermaker, one and two, as they have been now for four laps in a row. Then Fay runs third. Drew Nelson in his number three car, that 68 of Corey Hill. They're your top five. And then Terry Bartik in the 71. Coming to the checkered flag, Tammy Naslin, the 114 car, will be your first heat winner on Bud Jones & Sons Onamia Town Night here in the Pure Stock 100th of a second. But we can't put it up on the board. But we'll work on it. Siltman's going to bring him around. He's going to be on the pole. Dosh on the outside, trying to get a good jump. And side-by-side, door-to-door, down into turn number one. Hegeman gets away real slow off the jump there, and I'm not sure what's going on with the 33 car, but they're four wide, maybe three wide, down into turn number three, and that will not work. It never, ever does, as Larson very wisely backs out. Dosh gets pushed up the hill a little bit. Larson fades back to the fourth spot. Siltman's your leader, and Dylan Nelson rocks the number two spot. Craig Paul Jr. down into the fourth spot, gets under Devin. Still Siltman, Nelson, Dosh, your top three. Siltman leads him around still. Then it is the 25 of Dylan Nelson at the Klaus Stamping XL Painting. Number 25, that big bright blue car in the second spot. Dosh with the beautiful blaze orange number 12. And then the blaze orange theme continues in your fourth place spot. Hammer gets up into the fifth place spot after his odd start, as he just didn't go on the drop of the green flag there. But he seems to have her figured out now, and he is going hard. And up into the fifth spot, got around the 96 of Devin Larson. Going for the lead here, the 25 down on the low side. Siltman up on the high side in the 43. About halfway done right here as we have a new leader. The 25 machine of Dylan Nelson brings it to the front. Siltman falls to second. Dosh, Paul, and Hegeman and Larson have swapped positions on that lap as well. Two to go this time by. And Dosh making a drive down low into turn number one. Wisely gives way as he was going to get into Siltman pretty hard there if he didn't check up. And so he does that. Down into three for the second to last time. Dylan Nelson, he got up front and seems to be driving away just a little bit. Dosh again to the inside. This time doesn't give way, gets a little bit of a door bump, little rub. Nothing dirty going on there, just trying to share the same spot as Siltman goes up the hill a little bit. That opens the door for Paul, and he will be coming to the inside and looking for third, maybe more. Dylan Nelson's going to get the win in that cross-stamping Excel painting number 25. Then Dosh, Paul, Siltman. Jonesy looking him over, the lights are out. Zach looks up at Jonesy. Jonesy looks back at him and says, let's go racing, boys. So Zach with a great jump and down into turn one. Ashley tucks in behind him. Gill down below trying to get a little traction. And Sobraski comes out of nowhere and he is going to be fourth place by the time they go into turn number three. Hines goes far up the hill and it will be Zach Gill here. Sobraski, Johnson, Hines, and Reiser as they sort out and complete lap number one. Tommy Gill looking over at Dennis the Menace. Catching Dennis. That's one thing. Get around the number two car. Oh, that's a whole different story. And they all tuck into the bottom, playing a little Amtrak right around the bottom of the train, or the track, playing a little train is what my point making there. Zach Gill, Merriworth, Sobraski, and Johnson. That's a great picture. I hope Ben got a picture of that. We can make a still out of the video. Zach still leading. Sobraski making a move there for third on the 17 of Ashley Merriworth. He's down low, she's up high, and down low is going to get the spot. So your new third place driver is the 7-8. He's going to look over on Tommy Gill now. He's going to go right to the bottom. Gill's going to try to hold it down, but Shane got up underneath him, and he takes over the second place spot as well. So it's now Zach, Sobraski, Gill, Merriworth, and Johnson. And Hines and Reiser rounding out the field here in heat number three. Zach. Sobraski. Two to go this time by. So close to clipping that tire. Shane Sobraski wants that inside line, but Dennis is in it. One to go. Will the Menace hold off the Iron Man? Will Gill hold off Merriworth? And will Johnson make up any ground on either of them? Johnson making a move as well as Sobraski down to the inside of three. Dennis holds it right on the bottom. They're going to drag race down to it. And by a quarter of a car, the two holding off the 7A for the win here in the heat. Then Gill, Merriworth, and Johnson, your top five here. That's what I thought. And then Danny Vang, Tony Schilk, Billy Kendall, Scotty Engholm, and Dustin Joel. They are your participants in this heat. With a monster jump. And down into turn number one, and he is flying. Ryan gets pushed up the hill there just a little bit as he got a terrible push in that 07 car. And up the hill he went. He's looking for a flat tire or something. Billy Kendall holding off Scotty Engel for the 34. Billy the Kid running in that third spot. And then it is the 38 machine, a Dustin Joel. And Ryan having all sorts of trouble in that 07 car. And clearly, he is thinking something is up with that car because not getting on the gas super hard. into the turns, and in turn number one here, it is going up the hill. Driving hard, Schill in the second spot, Billy the Kid running in the third. Blue flag coming up for Ryan. Only just a couple laps in, he's gonna have to get that thing fixed up. Before the features. They go by Kevin Jones. And I'm having a thought. There's something I want to say, but I think it'll jinx it. So it has to do with the yellow flag. Just as I almost said it, Dykoff quickly gets off the track. Everybody doing a great job of avoiding him. And I'm not sure, kind of a little bit of a goofy start going on tonight for a couple guys that are usually pretty good. It is the 5X, however, of Danny Pedersen, comes from the outside of row number two. Pedersen and Merriworth. Off and running we go again. Still no laps down, eight to go. Here in heat number three, Nygren. Way on the bottom side, the 14X with a great start there. Jeremy Kurzman, and he's out front, the 5X machine of Pedersen. Somebody's done sound 100% tip-top going on down the front stretch here. And I think it might have been the 14X car. We'll listen. I'll be quiet. We can listen. You know what that is? That's the same noise that the Hornets make when they're hitting the rev limiter. He's got a rev limiter in his car. No, that's not true at all. Something is bad going wrong with the 14X car. Although he doesn't look to be slowing it down much. Maybe he does have a red limiter. I don't know what he's got in there, but it sounds a little goofy. The 5X machine trying hard to get around him. That's Pedersen and Kurzman driving hard in one and two. Maybe he's a steam engine. Sounds a little bit like a train. Merriworth, meanwhile, back in the third spot, making a great drive to the front here in that seven car. Then Nygren and Seidel rounding out the field here. I've never heard a motor sound like that in all of my years of coming to North Central Speedway. That's running as good as he is. He's still running fast, clean. No one's catching him. He's kind of pulling away from the 5X. Pedersen. I am 100% perplexed. Somebody that knows way more about cars has to let me know what's going on there. One to go. And Kurzman leading him around. Class of the field. The little engine that could. Train. Coming to the checkered flag, Pedersen with one last ditch effort to get to the front. It's not going to work though. Kurzman, Pedersen, Merriworth, 1, 2, 3. Then it'll be Nygren and Tigger. T-I double Gerger. His first race ever tonight, Isaac Sample, and then Peyton Nelson in the 5 car. And we're going green right now. Isaac, it's over. Isaac is 12 years old, by the way. Isaac learned how to ride a bike less time ago than before he has his driver's license. And so, he's doing great out there. He got her handled. He was getting a little squirrely, but he got her handled and fixed her right up. Hot Rod Berg, meantime, is up front and looking strong. Zipple making some moves on him, trying to get around him. His rod goes way up to the top, maybe kisses the wall just a little bit. And he had a pretty nice save there as Zipple goes by. Gallagher moves into the third spot. Fenstermaker, Keller, and Fletcher duking it out for the fourth spot. Oh, and I've got a spin on the backstretch as the 14 car goes. Then get up and beat and battle with the gang a little later on. Gallagher not going here on the start. I would assume had the hammer down, but just not rolling it. Now she's going. Maybe had it in a little higher gear than what she would think. But getting pulled on the backside there, too. So something a little goofy with that 13 car. Zipple. Berg. Bartell with a great save down into the sand and still saved it. Fletcher in the third spot. Then Keller, Bartell, Gallagher. And then Keller in the 14 car. And Lexi going backwards some more. So that car has definitely got some sort of issue with it, that number 13 green machine. The Pine Center Autobody, Bud Jones & Sons car. So they'll go back and put wrench to car and try to figure that out later on. And she's going to just pull it in, and they'll figure out what's going on with it. Blue flag will be coming out, I think, next time by for the 14 car as your leader, Jared Zipple. Josh Zipple is rocking it here, and he's quickly catching. Your lap cars could make a difference here in the outcome of the race. Lappers tend to make a difference. Hot Rod Berg. In the second spot, getting pushed by Fletcher. Fletcher to the inside. Nope, she thinks better of it. Hot Rod is going to go around the outside. He likes running that high line. And that's going to be the spot to be going down into turn three here as they blow by Sample. One lap to go for Josh Zipple. One lap to go for Hot Rodberg. And one lap to go for Fletcher. And she's down to the inside. Rod drifts up to the top again, keeping that momentum. And then the big Acura Power. Oh, they get together just a little bit going down the back stretch. Berg holding off for now. Fletcher, the winner is going to be Zipple. Berg comes home number two in the Brothers Motorsports Opatz Metals Cavalier. And then it'll be Fletcher in the Sun Drop, the Super Seth Kramer in the 68, and then Eric Tisi drives the 15T out back. Into the inside, Sasquatch up high, sweet. Cook, look at that gaggle. There's five cars battling for second spot. Make it six as Kramer slides down into the inside of check. Getz, meanwhile, is your leader. And now she got a new leader as Sasquatch quickly to the front. Getz will fall to second. Sobraski. Sort of a nose cone for Super Seth Kramer. And that'll be a little distracting for a ride here. Oh, and sweet. Gets all down. Looking the flag over. Johnson says, let's go racing, boys. Here we go. Sobraski gets a better jump than Getz does, and he might clean. D does clear for second spot. Meanwhile, Zipple gets a little crossed up and just about causes some carnage there. Kramer and TC, but now he gets her under control. And up in front they go. It is Sasquatch, the Iron Man, the Snake, and Super Seth. They're your top four. Then TC. Seth gets a really bad push in the 68. T of TC, it's down underneath, makes a drive. Zippel gets up the hill. That allows Sweet to come back through. And there's the two best battles between the 68, the 15, the 89, and the 27. They're in the back of the pack. But the one junior, the 7A, and the 26, they kind of got a little single file, a little spread out. And that does not make for exciting racing. To see when they're nice and close up, touching one another ever so slightly, but not being mean to one another. The gap not shrinking between the 1 and the 7, but the gap definitely increasing between the 7 and the 26. 68 maybe shutting down just a little bit onto the 26, but still not super close. You see the tear-offs flying as the debris flies, getting a little mud up on the visor. Throw a tear off, nice clear vision. Tim just out for a Saturday night cruise here at North Central Speedway. Shane digging hard and trying to catch him, but the one junior out there in the front at the nice clean air gets to choose his line, gets to choose where he goes, when he goes. And that's a hard, hard combination to catch, let alone pass, is that one junior out front by himself with no traffic around him. Gets Kramer, TC, Sweet, and Zippel. They are following around your winner, the one junior in the Woolen Construction Superstock here in your Coors Light Superstock Classic. Zabrowski gets the second spot, Getz gets third, then Kramer and TC rounded out the top five. So we wish Tommy a speedy recovery, a new car soon. Turn number one, your defending class champion at this track. It is the 37 of Dean Larson with a great jump. And down into turn number three he goes with the 36 machine of Ryan Boer. Hot on his trail. Geezy gets way up onto the high side. Climbing that hill. 76 runs in the third spot. That is Brandon Ferris. Started on the pole, drifted back to third. Right off the bat, Easy Geezy just trying to get up on him and get around. He's going to stay on the high side. It didn't work so well last time. Oh, but he gets right on the cushion. He's going to have all sorts of momentum coming down the front stretch here. Brown out back in the big orange. Geezy going to go low here as the 76 comes up to throw the block. And that's going to allow Ferris to, Ferris will be upside. Geezy will have the inside and a pass for third place. Meanwhile, back up front, Larson with his hands full of the number 36 of Ryan Boer. Boer starts high, cuts low, nice arc into the turn, then he tries to keep it right on the bottom, coming out of four to get up and get underneath Dean Larson. But Dean got it on a rope, and he is getting in and getting through and getting around the corners really, really nice in the Silver Bullet. As the laps dwindle down, 37 leads him around. Then it's Boer. Some distance back, but in third place is the 32X. Oh, and he got over the cushion again. Getting very, very close to the exit of turn number two. Easy. Seems to like that high line. He's got the wheels all slumped over, so he can do exactly that. He's run right up high. The 76, though, trying to catch him, and is maybe catching him, but then that momentum of the high line is working for Geezy. One to go here as Larson leads him into the last circuit of the track. 36 driving hard to get to the bottom, though. Boer with maybe a little momentum, and he's going way high. Larson drifts up, and will it be Larson by half a car length? That was, I think, another 75. And he gets safely off the track. Ziski in front, one and two. Esler holding off Larson there for third place. Not sure what's up with the sixth car, but come out and started the parade lap and then literally just never hit the gas, just coasted to the inside. So maybe knew he had a problem and didn't want to risk anything more. guy that fast the lead, then man, oh man, is it going to be tough to find him. And then you heard us talking, if you were here early enough, you heard us talking to Fun Times Fun, your number 21 driver. And a couple cool things there. That is a specially built Montour for his giant frame. He's 6'5" in the smallest cars that we run. And so his feet, like that white thing that you see right behind his front tire, that's his feet. They're tucked up that far. Larson, dive into the inside. And that was a checkers and wreckers kind of moment there as he literally drove right over Jerry Esler to get into the third spot. You saw that big jump there as he come out of turn number four. That was the rear tire of the 7L driving over the front tire of the 11. One drifts a little high, and that opens the door for Larson. And as we've seen, Larson's not afraid to walk through a wide open door. He did it just a lap ago. Esler, who drives a little bit better when he's got just a little bit of rage under the helmet. And I would suspect that that is the case right now. White flag coming up next time for the 24, the 21. I was talking about Funt there when the Fun time started behind him. But Funt, the driver of the 21, you look there, his number's black. Around to this side, you look, his number is red. We asked him about that during the driver interview, and he said, "I'm just really cheap, and I didn't want to cut two numbers for vinyl, so I just used the inside of one and the inside of the other on the other side." Race driver's got to save money when he can. Top of row number three, and then Chuck Olson in the 51, bringing him around. Prusser looking him over. And there we go, green. Prusser. With Sobranski to the outside. Prusser drifts high. Checks up. And they go blind like a freight train down low. Three wide underneath the 05. Sobranski will bring him around, and he will lead. And it's Fletcher Martini Jones. Then the Iceman. Ready to launch off for two fast and furious laps. Sobranski brings them down. Light goes green and we're off and running. Like he had studs in the tires down into turn number one, and he's already put 3-4 car lengths. Eichens and Martin. into turn number three. Look at that. Martini split the difference. We'll see you on the other side of the sun drop car. Fletcher goes from second to fourth. He's the guy that did not want to see that caution. He's going to get one back right here, though, maybe. Behind the steering wheel. So if you fancy yourself a driver, you got a couple extra grand that you want to dump on a race car, go talk to Mark Johnson. He'll get you hooked up. Amazing. Johnson brings him down into one. Timmy goes high, ducks low, and just like that, from fourth to second. First, second, first. He clears them and will be your leader first in just under a lap. Yezik runs second, then Dykhoff, Bartik, Wageman, the Rocket Man, and Billy Kendall in the nine. This is a pretty loaded up class right here. That's, I would say, loaded for bear. My dad used to say when I was a child. The Sasquatch pulling away, 3-4 car lengths between him and Yezik now. And every time he pulls out of the corner, puts another two on the field. Rocket Man coming up through there. He's into the fourth spot now. Gets ahead of Bartik and Wageman. Stays down low. And you'll be digging for more. Yeah, Dykhoff up in front. Goes into the second spot. Yezik falls to third. And maybe he's going to lose that to the 14J of the Rocket Man, Mark Johnson. Not yet. Maybe not ever. Kendall with a drive to get one more spot up in the running order. Look at the drive that Tim Johnson gets coming out of the corner. Look at the gap between the two of them just open up as he comes out of two and comes out of four. Dykhoff hanging on to the second spot. Rocket Man down low. Dykhoff drifted high just a little bit. A little uncrafted Daytona Talladega style going down the front stretch. And then a little chrome horn going around the corner there. That's a little Bristol Martinsville style. Still Johnson. Dykhoff, Johnson, Yezik, Wageman, Kendall, and Bartik is how they run right now. White flag coming up next time by as Jonesy waves the white laundry up in front of him. One to go for Timmy, for Kyle, for Mark, for Tony, for Sean, Billy, and Dan. Checkers for Johnson, Dykhoff. The Rocket Man gets dirty.
Young's not making it up.
And so Sack. Number one, Crookton, super fast to the front, getting around both Dick and Zach into the first place spot. Aaron Johnson up on the high side as well, and he's trying to hunt up third place, maybe second. Oh, the station wagon gets into him just a little bit. Nice save. Johnson gets around by himself. Stays there to make sure that the 17 doesn't get into him. And then we're off and running. And Aaron Johnson getting the real short straw here in heat number two. Crookton. Then Sack, then Dick. The 17 of Rodman. And then Aaron Johnson's going to have some ground to make up. But the Phenom out of Brainerd, he can do it. Looking super smooth, going around 1 and 2 in the 11K, the Dirt Race Central car. Crookton also sponsored by Opatz Metals, Race Fan 1, 2, 3, Seat Stainless, Nick Jaluski. Photo, Moments by Melissa in Lovin Auto Center. Come out of Bertram, and he is gapping the field here. Then it's Gary Sack, Danny Dick, the 17 of Justin Rodman, and Aaron Johnson, who is definitely closing down the gap between him, the 17, the 98, the 37, as the laps wind down. Let's look at some lap times here and see how these guys are rolling. Your fastest lap on that lap was the 442, last place, fastest guy in the track. Two to go next time, or this time by, one to go next time by. And the 442, again, your fastest lap. He jumped down low, he's gonna pass two, going down the backside. He'll have a lap and a half to go. Crookton looking easy breezy up front. Gary Sack, Aaron Johnson, officially fourth place, but again, the fastest guy in the track, the 442. Davey Crookton looking clean and green and black and white, as in black and white checkers, waving high over the 11K of Crookton. It'll be Gary Sack, the Phenom, Aaron Johnson, Danny Hill, and